गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ अजीत प्रताप सिंह। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो ऑफ क्लास सिक्स साइंस आई लेट यू नो अबाउट हाउ वी कैन सेपरेट इनसॉल्युबल सॉलिड फ्रॉम लिक्विड्स। ओके स्टूडेंट्स, सो वी कैन सेपरेट इनसॉल्युबल सॉलिड्स फ्रॉम लिक्विड्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ सम प्रोसेसेस और मेथड्स। द फर्स्ट वन इज सेडिमेंटेशन एंड डिकेंटेशन। इनसॉल्युबल सब्सटेंस विच आर हैवियर देन वाटर कैन बी इजिली सेपरेटेड बाई सेडिमेंटेशन एंड डिकेंटेशन। So let's talk about sedimentation process first. In the process of sedimentation, we generally remove the heavier particles of an insoluble solid in a liquid and that settle down, okay? Or we can say that sedimentation is the process in which the heavier particles of an insoluble solid in a liquid settle down, okay, and the particles that settle down form the sediment, okay. In the picture above, the written matter, you can see that a sieve being used to separate stones from the sand at the construction site. This is how the sieve is used to separate the sand from stones. Okay, students. Next process is decantation. In this process, we pour out the liquid without disturbing the sediment. Okay, if a solid dissolves in a liquid, decantation cannot be used to separate them. Okay, students. So the next process is filtration. In this method, let's take an example. To separate tea leaves from tea, you generally pour the tea through a strainer, which is a wire or a plastic mesh. The tea leaves are left behind in the strainer and the liquid flows out. This process is known as filtration. The strainer acts as a filter. The same strainer cannot be used to separate mud from water. The particles of mud are too fine and will pass through the holes. For this, we need a fine filter. A filter paper can also be used for this purpose. The filter paper that has fine holes which allow water to flow through, but not the mud particles. Okay, at homes and in offices or schools, special type of filters are used to remove solid impurities from drinking water. In these filters, a porous pot made of ceramic is used as a filter. As the water passes through the fine pores, the solid impurities are filtered out. In some of these filters, a special type of light called ultraviolet light is used to kill germs in the water. Okay, so now let's talk about the next process, that is loading. If the suspended particles of a solid in a liquid are very fine, very small, they take a very long time to settle down on the surface. For example, the particles of a clay in muddy water are very fine and their sedimentation takes a very long time. So loading is a method of speeding up sedimentation process. So we can say that by the help of loading, the process of sedimentation increases, and by this the particles become heavier. As we all know that alum, which is a solid which is insoluble in water, which is generally used to load suspended clay particles in water, okay? So if you will add alum in the muddy water, then the particles of the muddy water will come down on the surface very quickly. The dissolved particles of a alum load the fine particles of clay in water and they become heavier, as I told you, and settle down quickly. The clear water on top is then decanted or filtered. As you can see in this picture that there is a muddy water in a first beaker, and in the second beaker you dissolve alum or fitkri, we say in Hindi, in the muddy water. And if you will dissolve the fitkri or alum in this muddy water, then what will happen? The muddy water, the particles of the mud will come down on the bottoms very quickly because the alum makes the particle heavier, so they come down on the bottom very quickly. And in the third, because you can see the sedimentation can take place very easily, okay? and the clear water on top is then decanted or filtered. Loading of dust particles suspended in air occurs naturally when it rains. The first raindrops load the dust particles with water. They become heavier and quickly settle down on the ground. Okay, students, so this is also a fact. So that's it in this video.